we have reached a turning point in society. According to renowned theoretical physicist Michio Kaku, the next 100 years of science will determine whether we perish or thrive. Will we remain a Type Zero civilization, or will we advance and make our way into the stars? Experts assert that, as a civilization grows larger and becomes more advanced, its energy demands will increase rapidly due to its population growth and the energy requirements of its various machines. Since the same laws of physics would apply to all civilizations in the universe, we can reasonably assume a standard of measurement in terms of energy use. In 1964, Russian astrophysicist Nikolai Kardashev figured that civilizations can be categorized by the total amount of energy available to them. He called it the Kardashev scale. Initially, he came up with three civilization types: Type 1, Type 2, and Type 3. Other astronomers have extended the scale to Type 4 and 5. The energy available to this kind of civilization would equal that of all energy available in not just our universe, but in all universes and in all timelines. These additions consider both energy access as well as the amount of knowledge the civilizations have acquired. First, it is important to note that the human race is not even on this scale yet. Since we still sustain our energy needs from dead plants and animals, here on Earth, we are a lowly Type Zero civilization, and we have a long way to go before being promoted to a Type One civilization. Michio Kaku believed that, all things taken into consideration, we will reach Type One in 100 to 200 years' time. So let's examine these different types of civilizations and some of the things they can accomplish. A Type 1 designation is a given to species who have been able to harness all the energy that is available from a neighboring star, collecting and storing it to meet the energy demands of a growing population. This means that we would need to boost our current energy production over 100,000 times to reach this status. It is capable of interplanetary spaceflight and communication. Megascale planetary engineering. Medical breakthroughs to eliminate disease and slow aging. Multiplanetary government and interplanetary trade. Species is tech augmented, but is still vulnerable to extinction. A Type 2 civilization has control over their solar system and may be able to harness the power equivalent of a single star. It extracts fusion energy, information, and raw materials from multiple solar systems. It is capable of evolutionary intervention, interstellar travel, interstellar communication, stellar engineering, terraforming, and star cluster scale influence. The resulting proliferation and diversification may negate the probability of extinction. Complete control of the fate of its home planet, where threats like ice ages and global warming can be avoided. A utopian outcome would be a hybrid galactic culture with millions of cooperating worlds in a galactic community. Poetically, this would be a mammoth archipelago of solar system societies, a multitude of civilized islands separated by the vastness of the oceans of space. So we've gone from having control over a planet to a star, which has resulted in us harboring enough disposable energy to essentially make our species immune to extinction. But now, on to Type 3, where a species then becomes galactic traveler with knowledge of everything having to do with energy, resulting in them becoming a master race. In terms of humans, hundreds of thousands of years of evolution, both biological and mechanical, may result in the inhabitants of this Type 3 civilization being incredibly different from the human race as we know it. These may be cyborgs or cybernetic organism, beings both biological and robotic, with the descendants of regular humans being a subspecies among the now highly advanced society. These wholly biological humans would likely be seen as being disabled, inferior, or unevolved by their cybernetic counterparts. At this stage, we would have developed colonies of AI machines that are capable of self-replication. Their population may increase into the millions as they spread out across the galaxy, colonizing star after star. And these civilizations might build Dyson spheres to encapsulate each one, creating a huge network that would carry energy back to the home planet. At this scale, the civilization had already developed working warp drive that let them travel at light speed from different parts of the galaxy using wormholes. It is estimated that humans might reach Type 3 in 100,000 to 1 million years, assuming we can survive long enough without destroying ourselves. A Type 4 civilization would be capable of harnessing the energy of the entire universe. This civilization would be able to travel throughout the universe and consume the energy output of several, and possibly all, galaxies. It would be capable of manipulating space-time itself, granting it can obtain the things that we can only see in science fiction. It may even control entropy, possibly becoming immortal. Moreover, a Type 4 civilization would have tapped into energy sources unknown to us using strange, or currently unknown, laws of physics. They would also have mastered both dark matter and dark energy at this stage. This would allow them to open wormholes, live inside black holes, and perform many other feats that would be almost impossible for us to even imagine. Such a civilization would be indetectable, since its actions would be indistinguishable from natural processes. A Type 5 civilization are godlike. It would be advanced enough to escape their universe of origin and explore the multiverse. Such a race would have mastered technology to a point where they could simulate or build a custom universe. They will have mastered all the laws of physics and have almost complete control over the fabric of time, space, matter, and energy. So for now, this is the limit of the human imagination. But the Kardashev scale could definitely go higher and higher, depending on what types of theories emerge next.